Attention. Stand by for Tiberium Dangers update. Tiberium is named after the Tiber River in Italy where it was first discovered. There are now more than 200 areas of the Earth affected by Tiberium deposits. Tiberium appears to be spreading by means of conveyance unknown.
Dr. Mobius, tell our viewers just what Tiberium really is.
Molecularly, it's a non-carbon-based element that appears to have strong ferrous qualities with non-resonating reversible energy that has a tendency to disrupt carbon-based molecular structures with inconsequent unequal positrons orbiting on the first, second, and ninth quark rings.
Whoa, is that good or bad?
Well, let me put it this way, Eddie. The possibilities of Tiberium are limitless.
Well, now let me ask you, by limitless, you said that...
We now know that not only does Tiberium leach elements from the soil, but it appears to also leach vital nutrients from all plant life. Human contact with Tiberium is extremely toxic and often fatal. Exposure should be avoided.
Commander, you've been hustled. The UN wasn't against me. Not all of them, at least. But we had to play that little game to lull Kane into a false sense of security. I've unlocked some new UN funding. It should help take care of this madman for good. Morelli, we got some new toys for you. You've read the classified briefings about Orca, and here she is. I need you and Morelli to take a couple of these babies up and put them through the mill. Concentrate on a radius of 50 miles around Trieste, Slovenia, and see what you can scout up.
Hello everyone and welcome back to Command & Conquer Tiberian Dawn Redux and welcome to the 10th GDI mission. This time we're going to get introduced to the Orca. Well, not really, because we used Orca units in skirmish mode, but officially we do get introduced now. So let's establish our base here. And let's get a power plant as usual. Let's maybe split our forces a little bit so we can defend both of our flanks here.
Construction complete.
Yep, and yes, there.
Over and out.
Let's get a refinery right next to the Tiberium field. And let's get barracks as well. And build second refinery. Maybe not.
Construction so. Complete.
But maybe. Maybe another power plant here and then a guard tower also. I always like to have one or two guard towers just so.
Let's
commission a harvester. Did that actually increase my power? Oh no, it's probably just. Yeah, I have a harvester. Man, let's do the same here. So maybe have you explore just a little bit so we get a. Oh yeah, so. It's good, there's mountains here, or cliffs or whatever. That should make defending here a little bit easier. So let's get a second guard tower. And let's also get an arms factory, once we can afford one. Or maybe let's get some silos first. So we do start with the sandbags here. Same as in the original mission. I'm not really sure what those represent, maybe like a former base having been there, something like that. It's not really all that important, to be honest. Yeah, the Orca is GDI's basic air unit. In fact, it's really the only real air unit, if you want to use that term, because The other ones are the Chinook, which is not a combat unit. At least in the sense that it can't attack. And there's the Warthog bomber, but that only appears when you call it an airstrike, so it's not really a unit you control. And there's the Antonov plane, but that's an odd unit, and it's a transport plane, and now of course there's the Apache attack helicopter, which makes no appearance in the campaign. Even though you can play it in multiplayer, which always struck me as odd, because it's not like in the campaign you need to be worried about balance, because there it's the player against the cheating AI anyway, so it would be more, would make more sense if you had special units in the campaign that you can't play in multiplayer. Yeah, not quite sure why they did that. Maybe they added those later for multiplayer balance. I don't know. But anyway, multiplayer doesn't really have balance because not already has the Napalm Rocket Launcher, another multiplayer only unit. Well, it does appear in some of the covert operations missions. And then it also has its standard Nord artillery, and then on top of that it also has the GDI rocket launcher. And I never quite got that. Why does one side have one rocket launcher that actually needs an iron can control center to, advanced communication center to be built, and the other side has every single artillery unit in the entire game? I never quite got that. But hey, what do I know about video game design? A little bit, because I have worked as a game developer briefly. But yeah, that doesn't really make me an expert necessarily. I think I want a couple more of those just so I have some decent income, because NOT doesn't really seem to be too concerned about attacking me right now.
Construction complete.
So let's get maybe building. Three more of you, and let's also get a communication center for the radar scan and also to build the Orcas. So let's maybe place you here.
Building.
May as well.
Construction complete.
And you can move over here.
Building.
And here we go. And NOT doesn't really seem to be interested in. Oh, actually, wait. So they did attack me here. Wow, I completely overlooked that. So I guess they do attack me. So yeah, I'll take that back. Let's just see how. 1,500. So that's fairly expensive.
Yes.
But then again, you do get a free chopper with it, so I guess that's fair. Yeah, due to the fact that you would obviously build, let's just see, the knock base should be over here. Yep, definitely is. Yeah.
Construction complete.
I want to find out how effective air units are versus SAM sites. Because in the original game, taking out a SAM site took a lot of effort. I think here it's a little bit different, because I think in the original game the SAM site got a defense bonus when it was closed, or at least it always seemed to me like that. So maybe if it's not the case here, then we can actually clear out the map with air units, which wouldn't be cheesy because it's this mission's theme. So that goes to you, Chris. So let's build our first helipad. And let's assign you a number, and you
yes,
too.
You got it.
And air units should also help in with base defense, because they can probably take out a turret from a distance, stuff like that. So let's radar scan a little more. So they do have anti-air, and they do obviously have rocket guys and stuff, but I don't think it's terribly much, so we should... are they actually low on power? Or is this... wait, this is an independent obelisk of light? Maybe. Seems odd. In any case, let's build a couple more of these.
Building.
Here we go. Maybe like 5 or 6. See, it's my beautiful, beautiful orca. Whenever you build one of those, then it hops up when the building is finished. I think that's a technical limitation. I'm not sure whether that can be fixed. I'm not much of a general's modder. But yeah, just watch it. And
hop. Construction complete.
So let's get more of these. And even more of these. And then we can scan the map a little bit, because these guys can actually... they can probably scan the map and actually unveil areas. The original Orca could... What the hell are you doing? The original Orca couldn't do that. It would just fly through the Shroud of War, but not actually clear it up. Just do some random scanning here. There's also a lot of gun turrets on this map, and I think those pretty much exist to encourage you to use Orcas. Oh, anti-air. So let's see how effective we're here. Not bad, not bad at all. Because they probably aren't going to rebuild those, so that wasn't too bad of a deal. So can I... I should be able to repair these guys on repair pad. Yep, that wasn't too bad of a deal, I'd say. Yeah, so let's clear out the map slowly. And let's maybe build more of these, because you can't really have too many of them. And I don't think anybody else here is damaged. No, it doesn't look like it. So, you have recharged, so... Oh yeah, they do a pretty decent amount of damage. And didn't even see you guys, but I guess now you're dead. May as well unload your load on this guy here. Yeah, I'm definitely going to use those guys a lot in this mission. So yeah, this mission here is still in beta phase. So I'm doing some little testing here. It should work fine. I mean, it does work fine, except that it doesn't crash or whatever.
Building.
But yeah, maybe there are still some issues, like the one with Obelisk of Light, which then again isn't that big of a deal, so who cares? And if I cheese this unit, cheese this mission with air units, then it's not that big of a deal anyway. So let's... Oh. Always get a mild heart attack when that happens, because I think I'm going to run to another anti-air gun, but nope. It's just turrets all over the map. Should probably build more of these guys, because I guess I could build more of these guys. Actually, I don't think I can build more of these guys than we have pets. No. So there's essentially a hard limit on them. So here we go. Let's kill you as well. And here we go. And may as well kill you. Yeah, and I think these guys always move home when you don't use them for a while, which original Orcas did as well. Unless you told them to land somewhere. So here we go. Does those recharging animation actually correlate? It seems to correlate with the speed of you. Let's see what we have here. So we do have anti-air here, but there don't really seem to be a lot of units just lurking around here. So let's try and take out this anti-air gun. Oh, maybe we take out this anti-air gun here. Yep, maybe we do that instead. Hey, you guys are coming for me, to be honest, I don't really care. Let's instead rebuild you. And oh yeah, there you are. So it seems like these guys are either completely undamaged, or they get destroyed.
Unit reporting.
So where are you? Well, I've got a decent amount of money. Let's actually build some tanks and some artillery, because you never know when it's going to come for you.
Yes, sir.
So here we go. Let's try that again. Clear whatever's in our path. Actually, let's kill you first. And let's see whether there's more guns here. May as well do it now.
Construction.
These guys are so fast. Oh. Okay, that was actually pretty decent. Even those guys didn't last long. That's good. Because artillery is also fragile, so I probably don't have to be too scared about rocket guys. And you are repaired on your pad. That's quite convenient as well. So can do some more radar scanning. So, I don't think the not buggy is anti-air. Could be wrong, but I don't think it is. We'll find out soon. I think only the transporters. Let's kill you, and let's kill you. And here we go. So, may as well build even more of these.
Building.
It seems like Knot isn't very aggressive on this map here. Yeah, probably should be a little bit more aggressive.
Building.
And let's build one
building
more.
Lost.
Oh. Okay, so this is not what I wanted to happen.
Vehicle reporting.
So let's select all of you guys and let's just take off these turrets here. Here we go. Yeah, and the orcs, they also have a... I think they have a machine gun. Let's actually check that out. Or... comes with one orca. Here we have... heavy machine gun and dragon rockets. Ooh, dragon rockets. Okay, so now we should finally be able to move in here. And dismantle that base.
Construction complete.
It's actually radar scan, so I can go in here straight away. There we go. And let's maybe take out a power plant or two. And let's say that was pretty successful. Goodbye. So there's some rocket guys here, but that's okay. Doesn't seem like they killed anybody. At least I think they didn't. So, and so there's more. I think there were more anti-air units here, but still not that big of a deal. So, and they do attack me, but yeah, I think they should be more aggressive. So here we go. Everybody repaired. Looks good to me.
Yes, sir.
Let's move out again. And maybe I think I should take out these rocket guys here first. Otherwise they will shoot me every single time I get to the mod base. Okay, so actually I kind of like the machine gun because it probably means that I save the rockets for the actual hard targets. And here we go. Wow. They're dismantling this base in no time. Yeah, I'm totally going to use exclusively orcas here. Let's just check what we have here. More anti-air and actually a bunch of units. Not a big deal though. And I think I'm actually going to explore a little bit now just in case they have more anti-air on the map. Maybe I will actually... Oh, hey guys! Yeah, you... Yeah, there we go. Entire column destroyed. And did I lose? Nope, still didn't lose a guy. It's good. So I'm kind of glad that these guys get repaired by their pad, because otherwise I'd have to put them on the repair pad one by one, which would be a massive pain. What the hell? Whoa, I'm going to lose a lot of guys here because there's just too many rocket guys here, but that's okay. I can afford that, and it's still better than those guys reaching my base. Hey, glitchy rocket guy. Whatever. So, let's just see how many of these guys I just sacrificed. A good number, I guess. Okay, who's... You need to die right now. Okay, I should definitely build more tanks. Yeah, I'll build more tanks and more Humvees. And maybe notice a little more aggressive after all. And I lost four of those guys, which is okay. It's not too bad. And I did kill a fair amount of Nord units as well, so...
There's
a fair amount of anti-air here, but still should be manageable. Oh, okay, that was a waste. Yeah, but orcas are also surprisingly sturdy. I remember that from playing as Nord, where they did take a fair amount of punishment. Probably for the better, because otherwise it would probably be too easy to defend against them. It's of course nice, but at the same time you don't really want there to be no challenge whatsoever. But we'll see whether these guys are still as useful in later missions, because... So here we go, let's just take out all of you guys. That's so beautiful. Oh, no ammunition left, so I'll kill you next time. He's just some sort of hobo strolling around here, or maybe just a peasant. So here we go. And I think you guys should be sufficient to defend my flank here. But let's let's build some more artillery just in case.
Construction complete.
So.
Awaiting orders.
Oh. Hey artillery. How are you doing today? So I bet there's more anti-air somewhere here. And the question is there a UN crate in, or money crate in the church? Only one way to find out.
Yes, sir.
Well, the Vatican is not going to like that. But then again, where does this mission take place again? Could be in Eastern Europe, in which case would probably be... Well, since Poland would of course be the Vatican, because Poland is primarily Catholic. And I'll kill you next time. Or... It was elsewhere in Europe, it's probably the Orthodox Church, and I don't really know why I'm talking about this so much. So, my beauties, please recharge and repair. And then you're going to die. So let's just see how much stuff they're accumulating in their base. Not that bad. Lots of rocket guys, but we can help with that. So it seems the obelisk is out of power, which is kind of weird. Shouldn't really be. I mean, I did destroy power plants. But I think this guy was shown to be out of power from the very beginning.
Yes, sir.
In any case...
Construction complete.
Oh yeah, there's that SAM site.
Yes, sir.
So... Still have some juice left, so may as well explore a little bit more. Hey guys. And yeah, let's return home. So... There's one SAM site here. Just see how much anti-air there is here. That's a lot of rocket guys, but if I come from this angle, I should be okay. There's one here, and there's probably one here as well. I think I can actually take out all of those guys and finally use the airstrike when I'm supposed to use it. That'd be glorious. And they're still not moving these guys here. So let's take you guys and get over here. And then... take out this SAM site from this angle here, so I don't have to fly over all the rocket guys. Here we go. May as well kill you for good measure. And here we go. Yeah, these guys, they're really, really hit and run. They're essentially like flying knot cycles. So you get some artillery as well. It's not that I need the money for anything else. Anybody here? Oh yeah, actually, another SAM site. Yeah, they really went crazy with the SAM sites on this mission too. It is justified, but there's a lot more than I expect there to be. And here we go. And you can... Yeah. Yes, actually managed to take out all of that. So let's see where we... Yep, second try. Not bad. And no, don't think you can build more of these guys than you can have pads. They're essentially like the general's planes. You can only build four per airfield. I wonder, can you actually land Chinese planes on an American airfield and vice versa? I think you can. Never really tried that deliberately, though. So, let's take out you. I have to micromanage you a little bit here because otherwise you're going to fly over the base and... fly over all those rocket guys and probably get killed. I mean, I do have enough money to replace you. But I don't really want to risk it. Ooh, not cycles. May as well take them out. And if I lose a couple of guys here, it's not that bad. So here we go. They have a lot of stuff here. But that's okay. I've got the money to replace whatever I lost, so we should be good. Here we go, and here we go.
Reporting.
And again, the rest didn't really take all that much damage. You're juggling through here, artillery. Are your wheels actually moving? By which I mean your...
Construction complete.
Your treads are moving, which is a nice thing. I'm not really sure whether I did that in the original generals, for all units at least. Yeah, not really that important, I guess. So let's fly over here, because I bet there's at least one more SAM site. Well, there has to be one more SAM site somewhere, otherwise I'd have the airstrike already. So question is, where's that SAM site? any case, we may as well destroy that on our way here. Oh, that was bad. Or maybe not, because, oh yeah, that was bad. I mean, there could be one here. Did I overlook one here that I already uncovered? Doesn't quite look like it. And lost another two orcas. That's okay.
Building.
So, may as well explore a little bit.
Acknowledge.
Oh, I think one thing that Nod does the original mission is send some artillery pieces up this cliff here. And if you're not prepared for that, they're just going to kill you. But GDI does the same in one of the Nod missions. It's the one where you have to destroy or kill only a bunch of scientists, which is a trap by Seth. And Seth, not sure why I pronounced that with a double TH. And it's supposed to get you killed, or at least to have you fail, and then lose Kane's favor. But yeah, you can actually retrieve an old mod base in that mission. But if you... Ooh, yeah. You guys are dead. But if you retrieve your base in that mission, then GDI is going to send some of their medium tanks up one of those cliffs. Still don't get where that last anti-air gun is. Did I just overlook it? Oh yeah, oh it's here, yeah. Well, that was obvious. So I'm going to come from this angle and then we should be good, so. So you get over here. And I'm not going to fly over those guys again. Yeah, and you're going to get taken out via airstrike.
Airstrike ready.
Get over here. And oh, this is going to be so beautiful.
Airstrike ready.
This is going to be so beautiful. There come the Warthogs. Come on. Ooh, yeah, look at this. All those guys just burned. Ooh, yeah, beautiful. We're going to do this over and over and over again. So much is obvious.
Yes, sir.
So, and I think that's pretty much it for Nod. There's not much they have left to stop me.
Reporting. Acknowledge. Moving out.
Oh.
Acknowledge.
So let's... Not sure what the hell are you doing? So let's destroy their barracks, because I don't really want them to produce more. Woohoo. Well, I definitely need to call in an airstrike here. Yeah, whatever. I don't really care right now. I've got airstrikes, I've got orcas. This mission is essentially over. Once you guys have repaired yourself. What did you do that for? Never mind. Can destroy this guy here.
Construction complete.
Oh, and another Nod tank column, which we don't want to have at our gates. Well, one of them left. That should be alright. And you recharge. So, see what else they have here. So they have a fair amount of stuff left. So I'm obviously going to go for the airfield next so they can stop producing stuff. And my Warthogs need some time to recharge, so I don't think it's worth waiting.
Reporting.
Let's just get over here. And have them move in from this angle here. And no more income for you. Not that you actually... Nope. Let's get over here. There we go. That's better. Still lost a bunch of guys, but that's okay. That was essentially their last attack, because they have no production facilities left. So... Here we go. Oh, they sent out those artillery pieces. That's okay.
Yes, sir.
And where are you? Where are you?
Construction complete.
Oh, you were under construction. Well, never mind that then. So, yeah, I'm just going to move in, destroy the power plants and whatever else they have left. This very soothing music is, in my opinion, very fitting here. So, yeah, there goes your construction yard. Which actually took quite a lot of firepower to take down. And your power plant, and your other power plant, and here we go. Can't wait for my next airstrike. And oh, you're my harvester. That's okay. Gonna harvest there. And any more stuff coming? Nope. And there's a lot of craters here. Yeah, this patch of grass definitely isn't going to regrow anytime soon. I wonder what these orcas are based on. They have this hover technology, which could just be some sort of generic sci-fi hover technology that doesn't really exist. But I still wonder whether they're actually based on anything that at least exists as a concept. But I'm not quite sure. If you know, feel free to leave a comment. So. Okay, can I destroy that as well? Totally can. So, get out of here. And the question is, what do I want to airstrike? Yeah, I think I want to
select target.
Airstrike this
airstrike
here.
Ready.
There's also a lot of guys here, but I think it's more guys up here. And I need those guys out of the way to destroy the rest of the base. Ooh, and here we go. And I almost destroyed their refinery too, accidentally. So, and you guys are almost fit again. So, let's move in once more. Can actually start take out these guys here. Yeah, that wasn't that bad. Could have done that earlier, to be honest. And there we go. I'm actually going to move you guys. Nope, that's not what I intended. I'm actually going to move you guys over here as well. Because not like they're going to do anything to me, like launching assaults, because I don't really have the capabilities left for that. And you got promoted twice, not bad. And you're heroic. Even better, but you're probably going to get yourself killed soon. Or maybe not, because I don't really have all that much stuff left. As well, take out this guy here, because that always takes forever. Yep, literally takes longer than taking out a gun turret. They should just make everything they build out of whatever a Tiberium harvester is made of. I mean, it's not even that expensive. It costs 1,400, which would be acceptable if everything gets super sturdy. Then again, this game would probably just end up being like Command & Conquer 4, where every unit either has a super long health bar or super weak with regard to attack power, depending on how you see it. And the entire game is just complete slog, so... Oh! Still have rocket stuff left. Oh, and yeah, one more. Oh, and you almost killed my guy here. You actually killed my guy. Oh, come on. Well, he'll be avenged right now. Because you guys are going to... Oh yeah, there we go. Yeah, you... You're cocky. So, no. What are you doing? Following my commands, probably. No, get back home. What the hell are you doing? Anyway, now that you're here, you may as well take out that. That should, and yeah, did actually manage to take it out. So you guys take out these light tanks. Those light tanks always—they didn't really strike me as all that light. I have a feeling they're almost as tough as the medium tanks. Anyway, you don't scare me, Obelisk, now that you're out of power. Yeah, that's really the only downside with Obelisk, that it needs so much power. But apart from that, it's actually pretty good. It also saves a lot of space. I still like the... You can get over here. I still like the GI Rocket Tower better, because it's also anti-air and does area damage, so it's very good against infantry clusters. But the Aurors of Light also has this beautiful precision. So here we go. Blow up that, and let's blow up you. Probably should have blown up the units. Oh yeah, now that was their last building, so now they're going to do a final rush. And then this should be over. Yeah, this was almost exclusively a mop-up job after I established my orcas. So, yeah, these are definitely better than the original orcas. Oh, and they actually have engineers. I have to watch out for those, don't want them to take over my vehicles. And... nope, didn't make it. But I almost destroyed my own tank.
Yes, sir.
As well, so... oh,
yes, sir.
You're still left. And here
mission
we go.
Accomplished.
Yeah, having the orcas in this mission definitely helped a lot. Why did I lose a building? Oh, maybe I think I lost one of my guard towers. Anyway, this wasn't too bad, and this is again the last mission for now. But as soon as more missions come out, I'm going to LP those as well. So thanks for watching, and I shall see you next time. Take care and goodbye.